Okay, so I finally fixed the camera. I was having like this really weird red tint around me, but whatever, it's over. We're here. Welcome. I'm Dulce. What's up? What's shaking? I don't have a idea for this video, but what I can tell you is that I just feel like talking. So let me tell you something. It's been a while since I've actually done proper makeup. It's mostly because I've just been very tired, and I want to say it's due to the fact that I have been a little more active than normal. I have been, on my fitness, and I plan to be on my fitness today. So, I don't want to put on a lot of makeup, but I did want to get down here and put on some makeup. I'm not trying to put on a full beat or anything like that because I don't want to work out with makeup on. So, what have I been up to? Just clean the toilet, clean the sink, the little area around it, clean the mirror. When I get home from working out, I'm gonna clean the shower area. My nieces, they want to come over today and hang out. So, I'm gonna go pick them up. After this, I'm going to the park because my nephew's having a game. I'm gonna work out a little there, bring the girls home with me, come home, take a shower, clean the shower while I'm in there, which like knocks out one, like two things in one, just in case. Like, if I wanna go in there and put in a leave-in conditioner and I gotta be in there for a while, I put in the conditioner, turn off the water, and start doing scrubbing on the tile, because I really hate cleaning, so I might as well just do it there. But anyways, I'm gonna bring the girls over and we're gonna finish watching the Halloween movies. This is just a little lip gloss because my lips feel a little dry. Just now I put on some sunscreen from Supergoop. It's supposed to work as a sunscreen and a primer at the same time. Whatevs. Right now I'm just gonna put on a little brow from ColourPop, the Brow Boss Gel, so I don't look too crazy. I'm gonna be sweating, so I'm probably gonna end up mistakenly, unintentionally just wiping this stuff off. But like I said, I don't wanna work out with too much makeup on. It's mostly like my skin here, I don't want it to break out or anything like that. So anyways, how are you guys? Oh my God. So like I told you guys, I'm on my fitness, right? Since the last, so I used to be very active, and when I was, I weighed close to 150. The biggest I'd ever weighed was 160. And still, like, that was, I looked and felt fine. And when I say fine, it's like a soft fine, because I still feel very tired. There's a lot of people out there that'll tell you that when you lose weight, and you're trying to get a little more healthier, eat a little better, for your health and for comfort, you get energy back. And I'm here to tell you, I don't, that's not a blanket statement. For me, I remember when I was, as pork chop, I remember when I was getting fit. I was going to the gym regularly. My eating habits were okay, but they weren't bad because I was able to drop the weight that I wanted to drop. At that point in my life, I was going through some things, and working out really helped with my depression at the time. Anyways, so I let that fall by the wayside, and in addition to not going to the gym anymore, my eating habits became poor, and before I knew it, I gained 30 pounds and I was close to 200 pounds. So that was alarming. That is very much not normal for someone that's my height, and my age, and there are a lot of diseases that run the family. So I took it upon myself to, change a few things. I'm very uncomfortable right now. I don't like the way I'm living. I say all that just to say I've been through my healthiest, I've been through my most unhealthiest, and all in between. And so I went to the gym at my healthiest, so going to the gym now, my most unhealthy. And I'm just here to tell you, like, there back then when I was fit, I was tired all the time, just like I am now. Like so when people say like, oh, it gives you so much energy and this and that, like, I don't know, like maybe it had something to do with the way I was eating or something, but I did not feel energetic all the time. Like I woke up in the morning at a reasonable hour, like 9 o'clock, 8 o'clock, went to the gym for about an hour, took a shower, went to work, and I was tired. I was dog tired. She's so cute. I was dog tired, and I don't know what they're saying when they say, like, I don't know where they're getting this from, where it's like that you just feel amazing after that, you know? Like, you feel your best. Oh my God, you get so much energy. I want to do things. And I'm just like, no, not I. I wasn't like, it, that wasn't my journey. It didn't happen to me like that. But I will tell you this. Now I'm eating a little better. You know, that is one of the focuses. In addition to just being more active, because I'm not doing hardcore regimens or anything like that. But I am doing a little more movement, and I'm shooting for 5 times a week, but so far it's only been average 4 times a week. And I do feel now, I feel like I found like a happy medium, you know, because I don't feel as tired as I used to. And I think that's so funny because I'm at my heaviest, and the only change I made was just the way I've been eating and just like just a little more movement, and I feel better. So maybe the part that I should focus on is, you know, because I have heard this, that you can't run from, or you can't run with a bad diet, or you can't run away from a bad diet or a bad eating habits, you know what I'm saying? So, and it probably, and it helps a ton that that Adam's a vegan. That limits our options. We're not, you know, running to all the fast food chains all the time and stuff like that. So I don't know. I'm telling you that to say, like, everybody's journey is different, you know. This is what I was looking for. So yeah, I just wanted to give you an update on my weight loss journey. Again, this is my choice. I will not be made to feel bad about my choice, because I am very uncomfortable, like physically uncomfortable. I just feel like it's hard to move in my own body, and if I want to lose my this weight, it's my body, my choice. I've lost about 5 pounds, so I'm pretty happy about that, and I celebrated with a bowl of grapes. So yeah, that's the update on my fitness journey. The other update is that I am so excited about the new Animal Crossing update. Let's talk about that. Oh, and what I just put on my eyes is just the app, what is it? The Super Shock Shadow called Frog from ColourPop. And this is the Electric Mood Mascara. I started playing Animal Crossing in August, and I got hooked real easy. And the funny thing is when I got my Switch, I got it for my birthday. I got my Switch and I was like, cool, I have the Switch. And I went ham. I bought like 4 games. Luigi's Mansion, Dragon Quest, Animal Crossing, Chicken Police, which is like a visual novel. And that was it. Oh, and Cooking Mama. I bought Cooking Mama because I was a big fan when I had that game when back when the Nintendo DS was new. And so I bought that game. So, hated Dragon Quest. Didn't like it. I left Animal Crossing till the very end, and I saw that there was like a huge following. It was like the game of 2020. And I was like, it looks stupid, but you know what? I'm gonna buy it anyway. Whatever. YOLO, right? So I bought it, and oh my God, I love that game. I love that game, and I play it twice a day. And I also got the Nintendo online subscription. I got it, oh, and this is a Juvia's Place concealer. Remember when I said I wasn't gonna buy it because I didn't need concealer? Well, I have it and I love it. So yeah, I got the game and I am hooked. I got the online subscription thanks to a Patreon. He sent me money, and he specifically said, "This is for your Nintendo online subscription." I guess he just suspected that I'd have more fun having the subscription, and he was absolutely right, because I'm able to play a game that I haven't played since I was in elementary school, is Donkey Kong Country from Super Nintendo. And I played that game front to back so many times. And I'm thoroughly enjoying it. So now they're having a free update for Animal Crossing. They're having a paid expansion. Like, you have to pay for the expansion. It's like an addition to, like, a, I guess, like an some add-on features. And it's huge to the Animal Crossing franchise on Nintendo. And in addition to that, they're expanding their online membership to include games that were previously on Nintendo 64 and on the Sega Genesis. So if you buy the expansion pack with, like, if you're going for that expanded online membership, you get the Animal Crossing expansion pack that includes, like, you get to go to different islands and set up vacation dream homes for, like, different animal villagers, which I think is amazing. So I'm pretty excited about that. You can't tell me nothing. But yeah, so I'm pretty excited about that. And that's just my life right now. And I think it's hilarious. My husband thinks it's funny because I'm always talking about, and this is just setting powder from Fenty. My husband laughs whenever I talk about the game and, you know, that I'm excited about these things, because, like, I wasn't big into games. Like, the only kind of games that I was big into were arcade games. I'm still very much a fan of arcade games. We have this bar by, in Houston, not by us, but it's in Houston, and it's called Cider Arcadia. And basically, you pay $10, you go in there and you play all the games that you want. There's no tokens, there's free start over, so you can literally sit there in front of an arcade game, beat it from beginning to completion, and with no tokens. You just hit the restart button or the player one button to restart, and you're good to go. The only thing that you have to pay for are the pinball machines, and I'm not pinball queen or nothing like that, so I don't really mess with them. But yeah, crazy. So, and now I'm just using, like, the ghost edit palette from Hourglass. This was like 2 holidays ago that I got it. These are really nice powders. It's a shame that I gave my money to them a long time ago, but it's a shame that they're not as inclusive as other brands are, you know. But like I said, I already gave them my money back in the day, so might as well use it, especially because it was expensive. So since we last talked, I did do a declutter, so I'm down to 48 palettes. I can't believe I had so many palettes, but I did. That was me. That was my journey. Doesn't have to be your journey, but it was mine. And I feel lighter. Is that weird? Is that a weird thing to say, that I feel lighter? Because I do. And I think it has everything to do with decluttering. Our space is just so small. So I decluttered those. It was like, I want to say 8 palettes that I decluttered. So, and it was palettes that I really didn't think I was going to declutter. I mean, you saw my, you know, here's my palettes video. I had, I actually decluttered my Pat McGrath palette, the mega palette from the last holiday. Because what I've been doing is I'm pretty sure I told you guys, I've been giving everything a second chance. And 8-hour days, man, that's the test of time that they have to prove themselves to me, especially those mats. And I am here to tell you that I'm very sad that that palette did not stand that test of time. But it is what it is, you know. And so I sold it. I got some change for it, you know, like some coin for it. I sold it on Mercari. I sold the Raw Beauty Christie. Can you believe it? That one did not stand the test of time, and I went ahead and sold that. A lot of the ColourPop palettes, man, they're very disappointing when it comes to pigment, like pigmentation lasting you that long. And it's really sad, but I mean, they're inexpensive if you're not working 8-hour days like that, you know, or you're not fussed about it. I mean, sure, they're a good option, but for me, that's not what I'm looking for. Anyways, so if you check out the beginning of my, or like the, what do you call that? Like the entrance to my channel, you'll see that I have a brand new banner. Our friend Lindsay, Art of Aquarius, she designed that for me, and I am very proud of that banner, very proud of her work. I think she is very talented. I think it's really awesome that she can use her hands and digital mediums to like make these beautiful images, or just take the seed of anyone's idea and craft something like that, you know, with time and just your hands. Like, it's amazing to me. It's like magic. It's like I have it up there, this in my head. It's on the same level as people making beautiful architecture, making these buildings, designing these things. It's right up there with that kind of that level, you know what I mean, of making magic like that. And she nailed it on the head with that banner, because I had it in my head what I wanted, and she delivered and then some. So thank you very much, Art of Aquarius / Lindsay, for doing that for me. I don't know. I think it's really cool that you were put in my path, and me and Adam's path, and you're able to do those things for us. It's like a happy coupling of, you know, because I don't know if you guys out there have tattoos on you or anything like that, but like I obviously like tattoos. And when I have ideas for tattoos, or if I am just looking for an artist, you know, you can't just, well, I can't just go out there and just drive up to any old shop, Google a shop, drive up there, and expect to be happy with the tattoo that they give me, because I have a style, I have preferences, and say I go in there with an idea, and no matter how hard the artist tries, they are not nailing what I want. And that has nothing, it's not the fault of the artist, it's just that their art is just not my vibe, not what I'm looking for. So they can't execute the idea that I want, because they have their style as well, and our styles are not meshing. So it's, for me, I actively look at portfolios to see, okay, if I throw an idea at this person, will this person be able to nail it? Their technique, am I happy with their line work, with their you know, that kind of deal? Do they often work with themes that I enjoy, so that way I can feel more confident about giving them the idea that I want, and they'll be able to design something for me and execute it for me, and I will be 100% satisfied. So it's work, is what I'm trying to say. The long and short of it is that it's work trying to find that artist for you, for me, you know. That's my tattoo journey. So that's why I thought it was really cool when, you know, our podcast, like Adam and I's podcast, we did the podcast, and this person just gravitated towards us, started listening to us, and we were exposed to her art, and we were exposed to each other's crafts, and we meshed so well. And now she's, I would say she'd be my go-to when it comes to making something out of nothing, basically creating something out of nothing, just an idea, and she can work wonders, and I like it automatically, you know. That's a beautiful thing, and it's, for me, it's rare, you know. But yeah, so I don't know, I just just really happy with the banner and the logos and stuff. So but anyways, so that's the video. This is my makeup. It's very nothing. But it's gonna do the trick. I need to redo my nails, but yeah, so anyways, I hope you guys are having an awesome day. My homework for you is call someone that you love and tell them you love them. Okay? Do something that you want to do today, something that you've been putting off, and go from there. You know, just get your feet wet and see how you like that. Whether it's trying a genre of movie or type of food or that restaurant that you've been putting off trying for a while, do something different today. So that's me. That's the video. It's very short. It's shorter than my normal videos, but I wanted to sit down, record something, and connect with you guys. Check in with you guys. I don't know. The universe works in such a way that I feel like the universe talks to us through each other sometimes. And I find that a type of media, a person, whatever, or some words get put into my line of vision on a daily basis. And there are always messages that I need to hear that day, you know? So anyways, hope you guys have a good day. Remember what I said, your homework. And yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye.